At the 2014 Labour Party conference in Manchester, the Salvation Army held a fringe meeting, focusing on partnership with local councils on homelessness. The guest speaker was Shadow Minister for Communities and Local Government, Roberta Blackman-Woods.
Clearly, the Salvation Army have a very long history of working with homeless people and providing shelter, which is really important. It's a sort of social issue that we think Salvation Army understands very well, and they understand some of the solutions. And you know, one of the things we're going to be talking about today is what Labour and government could do to support the Salvation Army and its partners in their work.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's lovely to see so many people here. My name is Rowena Davis. I'm your chair for today. And I'm also a huge and dedicated fan of the work of the Salvation Army. I was shocked to read the briefing pack, which showed just how much homelessness is increasing on our streets. According to the last autumn count, we're up 37% since 2010, which was the first time that the homelessness rough sleepers count was started. And that seems to be a shocking and damning indictment of the way we're doing policy at the moment. I would like to ask Roberta to speak first, and we'll have 5 minutes each before opening up to you and hopefully having a very good debate. So thank you very much for being here. Roberta.
I think I'll stand up if that's okay. I really thank you very much for that introduction. As the Salvation Army know better than anybody else, the reasons for homelessness are very complex, and you often need a whole range of services to be able to address that issue. And actually, the Salvation Army is showing some of the way with this, working with our local councils. And that's really where I come in from, the Shadow Communities and Local Government team, because we want to see what we can do to support those partnerships, and in particular to roll them out. That best practice that is being developed across the whole of the local government sector. So I hope you can see that we've got an overarching approach to this issue. Thank you.
Speaking next was the Head of Homelessness Services for the Salvation Army, Mitch Mina.
Well, first of all, it's good to see you, and we're very grateful for your interest and your support here this afternoon. Homelessness is a problem that won't simply go away. For all sorts of reasons, people face tough times and they fall through the net. But doing nothing is expensive. Homeless people use the health services more than other people. Treatment services can be much more expensive to deliver to people without stable accommodation and support. Other costs may be incurred by the interactions of homeless people with the criminal justice system, the benefit system, and other outreach services. So you see, there are good reasons, there are sound reasons for public funding and for support services for people who are homeless on both moral and financial grounds.
Next, Yvonne Connolly described the impact of sanctions on people that she works with in Wales.
Every day we work with service users who are affected by sanctions, and every day the personal cost appears to be increasing. For many of our service users that we work with, the current system of sanctions can be counterproductive. We are seeing increases in anxiety, in stress, in isolation, in insecurity, and in desperation, all at a time as when we, as a support provider, are working hard to engage service users to overcome these very same issues.
The Salvation Army recently won the contract to provide homelessness and ex-offender services for Coventry Council. Faye Abbott is a councillor there.
In the past, in Coventry, we had 22 contracts which covered our homelessness and ex-offenders provision. So a bit of a challenge for the council to manage. With the funding cuts from national government, we had to think about ways of doing things differently. So what we did, we went out to tender, and the Salvation Army won the contract to be our prime service provider across all of our homelessness and ex-offender provision. It's a holistic provision, and it's about getting people back on their feet. Thank you.
Any questions for our panellists at all shared experiences. Lady here.
I really just wanted to ask about identifying people that are homeless. Sometimes it's a case that people will go along to their job centre and not always class themselves as being homeless because they're living in temporary accommodation or with family. And I really just wanted to ask about what we could do to sort of address that issue.
Are you thinking about smaller contracts and homelessness? Are you thinking about how you link it up with social care? And are you thinking kind of bringing back the rough sleepers unit as it worked? Thank you.
Secondly, just around No Second Night Out, we've obviously seen this government is one of the things it really has achieved, actually, is actually rolling this out. But what's the future of that in the Labour's vision?
Just wondering what you're doing, or can you give some examples of how you're working with a food bank? Or a number of food banks, Trussell Trust and other ones. Thank you.
I was just wondering whether you think that employment support services for homeless people should be delivered by specialist organisations such as yourselves who are working with homeless people in other areas, or whether they should be accessing mainstream provision.
For many of the people who live within a Salvation Army lifehouse, employability is a big issue for them. Whilst our staff will help service users in terms of employment and employability, we tap into the experts who are in the community as well.
You know what, we need to be looking at extending this partnership to allow local authorities to run job centres, because I just think with their local partners they should do a better job to support people than certainly I'm experiencing at the moment, and I expect other people are as well.
Before the meeting finished, Mike from Manchester shared his experience. He became homeless after he lost his job.
For my part, the Salvation Army has been remarkable. Everything they do from the day you arrive to your exit point, which for me is in a week or two's time, I've just secured my own accommodation. But I couldn't have done it without the help of the Salvation Army. As clever as I think I am, they can just get through to people like you can't. For example, benefits. You try phoning the benefits agency they just won't talk to you. They'll fob you off. Ask a member of staff at the Salvation Army to phone the benefits agency on your behalf, and they get a response like that. It's incredible. So for me, it's been a very positive thing. They deserve all the acclaim that comes their way. They're just incredible service. Incredible service.
Thank you for listening and being part of the debate. And please, let's just thank the Salvation Army and our panellists and yourself. Thank you. It was a really good event. The Salvation Army always puts on excellent debates because they have in the room people who actually work with homeless people on the front line and homeless service users themselves. And so when you get those people in the room faced with a politician, the debate is honest, it's refreshing, and you always come away learning something. So
I'm feeling really good about today. We have the Shadow Minister with us, to have the councillor from Coventry, who we've got a particular relationship with, contractual relationship, and a great turnout, some really good questions, and therefore I think there's a lot for the Salvation Army to go away home and think about and plan for the future.